I found out about the blue-green algae tracker driving home one day listening to VPR, the Vermont Public Radio, and I thought, wow, this could be a really good tool for me to use to figure out where to take my kids to the beach.
Blue-green algae are a type of bacteria, and they occur naturally in water bodies here in Vermont, as well as water bodies in the country and around the world. Blue-green algae can affect health if people come in contact with the blue-green algae. They can experience skin rashes, such as redness and itching. And if people accidentally swallow water that contains blue-green algae cells, they can have some flu-like symptoms and some GI distress.
The development and the improvement of the blue-green algae tracker has really been a partnership with a lot of entities outside the health department, but also between the tracking program and the climate change adaptation program within the Division of Environmental Health.
Because of the tracking network, the blue-green algae monitoring program is able to inform the public, beach managers, public drinking water suppliers of current blue-green algae conditions.
The tracker has really allowed us to address environmental health issues in Vermont by giving us the tools that we need to communicate with the public when there's a blue-green algae bloom.
The Vermont blue-green algae tracker uses crowdsourced data by networking with many citizen scientists, volunteers who send in regular reports about lake conditions. We also have professional scientists that do the same thing, who work for the state or who work for Lake Champlain Committee. And we're able to take all of that information and quickly get it onto a web map that the public can see.
The Lake Champlain Committee works with the Vermont Department of Health on this blue-green algae monitoring program. We recruit volunteers. The volunteers go out and make observations, and then all of their observations are entered into the Department of Health's tracker to be shared with the general public. The monitors are trained to go out, look at the water, and determine whether there's no blue-green algae present, some blue-green algae present, or quite a bit present. The tracker educates the public on blue-green algae by providing a one-stop place to look at the conditions all around the lake. We report conditions not just where blooms are, which get broadly reported, but we also show the public where blooms aren't. And that gives a much more realistic assessment of the health of Lake Champlain and the prevalence or absence of blue-green algae blooms.
So when the public comes to our blue-green algae tracker website, they're able to access lots of information quickly. They can very quickly, for first off, see whether the area that they're interested in is generally safe, or whether there's a low alert or whether there's a high alert.
It's really easy to use the tracker. You just bring up the website and the map pops right up on the screen, and all of the different beaches are coded by different colors. So if it's red, it tells you that there's a potential problem. If it's yellow, it's questionable. And if it's green, then you're good to go. When I look at the map that's on the tracker, it makes it real easy for me to decide which beach is open and in good shape and is close to where I am.